now at 6, heavy hearts for a local hero. The Cincinnati Fire Department grieving the loss of one of their own.
We could just use the community's prayers and the prayers for the family.
Daryl Gordon, a brave veteran firefighter, killed while trying to answer a call for help.
They couldn't get down. They had to go up there and get them down. It was just crazy.
Tonight he's being remembered for rushing in when others were rushing out.
And if there was somebody that truly was a hero, that epitomized what it is to be a firefighter, what it was to be a man, it was Daryl Gordon.
Today is obviously a terrible day for us in the fire service. We lost a family member. We look upon ourselves as family. It's the way we treat each other, and family takes care of family.
And they're going to tell you firefighting is more than just a job, it's a family. And when a firefighter is killed, all departments mourn. WLWT News 5's Brian Hamrick is live tonight with more on the amazing show of support as other departments spring into action to help out. Brian.
Yeah, Mike, more than 200 firefighters from Columbus alone are expected down here. And we're hearing from one department after another around the city who are filling in for firefighters who want to go to the services.
The Cincinnati Fire Department is thanking 19 other departments for providing staffing or equipment so Cincinnati firefighters could attend Daryl Gordon's funeral. Crews from as far away as Columbus either used Cincinnati Fire equipment or brought their own to cover firehouses during FAO Gordon's funeral and procession. Among the helpers were firefighters from Hamilton, Norwood, Covington, plus many other communities. Those volunteers made a total of 94 runs in a 12-hour period.
But at least for one day, Cincinnati firemen can rest assured their jobs will be taken care of. While they mourn the loss of one brother on Wednesday, hundreds of brothers will take their spots on those trucks, paying their respects through service, just like firemen would do.
At the end of the day, when we need one another, firemen are always going to be there for them. You know, they're going to be there to help the public. They're going to be there to help each other. It's just the nature of who we are.
We're here at station number 9 in Paddock Hills. There were firefighters from the city of Reading and the city of Columbus manning this firehouse today and other firehouses throughout the city so Cincinnati's firefighters could mourn the loss of FAO Daryl Gordon. At station 31 in Oakley, firefighters from Columbus came on duty at 6 o'clock this morning.
Everybody up there in Columbus didn't even think twice when we were asked if we could come down and cover for Cincinnati when this happened. It's coming for our brothers.
This is the second time Columbus Fire Captain Sean Funk has manned a Cincinnati firehouse. He came down for Oscar Armstrong's funeral in 2003. So did Battalion Chief Jack Reel.
We're not here to bring any attention to ourselves. We're here to make sure that those guys can do what they need to do so that their grieving process is complete. That's what we want to do.
The road is long, with a many a winding turn that leads us to who knows where.
All I know.
my brother. It's a long, long road. From whence there is no return. While we're on the way to there, why not share? He's my brother.